Now, once you've set up the layout of the app, it's time to take a moment to talk about what's actually happening in the final app. If you remember, we have the map on the screen, which is somehow modified by pressing the buttons at the top. Now, thus far, we've learned how to make a map fragment and change that through user activity, but we haven't learned how to create a Google Map object, which is the thing that within code will be able to change the contents of the map fragment. So to do this, there's a few things that we need. First of all, we'll need to implement the onMapReady callback. Now we'll do that by modifying the class declaration for our main activity to have this. So here I have my onMapReady, which is just setting mapReady a Boolean to true, and then this local variable called mMap to map. Now you notice here it passes back a Google map, so my mMap, of course, is a local instance of a Google map, and you can see I've defined it at the top of my activity here. And of course, the activity itself has to implement the onMapReady callback. So within onMapReady, I'm just saying the mapReady is true. I'm loading my local instance of a map with the one that was sent back to me. I create a new lat long, which I'm calling New York, with the latitude and longitude coordinates we used earlier on. Then I'm setting the camera position using a camera position builder. I'm targeting at New York, and I'm setting the zoom to 14. So it'll be a little bit further out than the one we saw earlier. And then on mMap itself, now the map object, I can call the move camera on that to set its position to be this target. As you can see, it's pretty straightforward. And you can do other things like angling and zooming to different levels and different types of views that you want on the camera position itself. But here I've created a very basic camera position. So that's all that you really need to do to get your map set up for working within an application and having a handle on a map object that you can then program. And I'll show you in the next step how we then program that to allow to have satellite or hybrid views.